Good morning to everyone and a very happy new year to all. At the outset, I'd like to thank Mrs. Hema Muni Venkatappa, Special Secretary Finance of the Government of Andhra Pradesh, for agreeing to chair this workshop on NPS for state autonomous bodies. I would also like to thank the Government of Andhra Pradesh for making it possible for arranging this workshop. Now, the national pension system has been in force since 1/1/2004. It is the NPS scheme is covered under the Pension Fund Regulatory Development Act of 2013, which got notified in 2014, and all central government employees to begin with joined NPS from 1/1/2004, and since then a large number of state governments and union territories have also joined the national pension system. So today we have about more than 30 lakh state government employees who are members of the NPS, in addition to about 6.35 lakh employees of state autonomous bodies all across the country who have joined NPS. So it's a ever-growing number of subscribers in NPS. And coming to Andhra Pradesh, we find that Andhra Pradesh was one of the first state governments to adopt a national pension system in 2004 itself, although the notification came in 2012. And we find that about 30 state autonomous bodies have joined a national pension system. But there are at least 60 more, according to our figures, who are eligible to join NPS. And I would urge all of them to join NPS as soon as possible, because there are clear benefits to joining NPS, as the fact that a large number of state governments and SABs all across the country have done so. So, and I'll briefly spell out some of the benefits that are available to subscribers who join NPS. First of all, it's a very attractive product in terms of the returns that the NPS provides. Since inception, the NPS has generated a return in excess of 10%, which compares with the best in the industry. Now, in addition to that, it's a very portable scheme. So, no matter where you're posted, the account, you don't have to make any changes to your account. It stays as it is. So, whether you are posted in the north of the state or south of the state or wherever, your account remains one and remains unchanged. Then, it's a very transparent scheme. We put out all the performance details on our website. Besides, we also have this NPS application, NPS app it's called, where you can get a lot of information relating to your account and the performance of the fund at any given point of time. There's a whole lot of information which is available on the NPS app. Then, since we are the regulators of NPS, it's a very well-regulated scheme. It's covered under the Act, as I mentioned. And there are many regulations that we have passed in order to protect the interests of subscribers. Now, in addition to all this, there is the tax benefit which is uniquely available only to NPS in the form of the additional 50,000 rupees tax deduction available from your taxable income, which is over and above the 1.5 lakhs tax deduction that you get under 80C. So this is an additional benefit of 50,000 rupees, which is available only to NPS subscribers, and a lot of people are joining NPS to avail of this benefit, and all state autonomous body employees can also avail of this benefit by joining NPS. Then in addition, we have what is called a Tier 2 account. So in NPS we have a Tier 1 account, which is the principal retirement account, and in addition to that, you could have a Tier 2 account, which is a voluntary account. It's like a savings bank account, you know, because there are no restrictions on the amount of withdrawals and deposits you can make in the account. And the good thing about the Tier 2 account is that the monies are invested in the same kind of assets as it is done in the case of the Tier 1 account, which is the principal retirement account. And therefore, the returns on Tier 2 match those in Tier 1. So Tier 2 accounts have also been generating returns of around 10%. So this is almost like saying that, you know, you are having a saving bank account which gives you a return of almost 10% per annum. So it's a very attractive offering, And this is also something which is uniquely available only to national pension system. So I would urge all those state autonomous bodies who have not yet joined NPS to please do so quickly, so as to avail of these, make available these benefits to your employees, so that they don't lose out on the benefits that the current subscribers of NPS are already enjoying. I am sure this in this workshop, a lot of doubts and questions that you may have will get answered, and I hope that at the end of the workshop, you are convinced to join NPS as quickly as possible. Thank you very much.